Hi and welcome to my channel. Today I am doing kind of a fantasy nerd painting. I've been really, really into Game of Thrones lately and reading it and watching it, and yeah, so I'm painting some dragons. I'm really excited. But so I'm really into fantasy art in general, and I just really wanted to draw some dragons flying over a castle. I think that they're friendly dragons and they're coming back home, but they could be mean dragons and they're attacking the castle, although they're friendly dragons in my world. So I started with an underpainting. If you've watched my other oil painting videos, I usually use a really thin layer of oil paint. I thin my oil down by using some mineral spirits, and I just do an underpainting. It dries probably in about an hour. And this just gives me a good idea to do color blocking, like a base of color, because I'm painting in an impressionistic style. And I'm applying the paint on really thick, so generally you won't even see the underpainting, but I just like to do one. After my underpainting is dry, and you see me doing this right now, I go back in with the colors I want to use for the painting, and I apply them pretty thick. Sometimes I thin my painting with a little bit of Galkid. Galkid is an oil medium, and it lets the oil dry a little bit faster. So oil has a pretty long dry time. I tend to find that my paintings are dry to the touch in a week or so, but if they're really thick, the oil could still be a little soft in that area. Galkid reduces the drying time a little bit. However, if you're like me and you really like the thick impasta style technique, you don't want to use too much Galkid, or another thinner is linseed oil, although linseed oil increases the drying time. So Galkid decreases, linseed oil increases. But if you want the thick, heavy lines, you don't want to thin your oil paint too much, because most thinners will also like smooth out the oil, and just it makes it harder to get like the brush strokes to stay. And when I'm painting in this style, I really like the brush strokes in it. Oftentimes, especially like in this really dark area, and it is hard to see, the camera's not picking it up that well, but I will actually pick up one or two different colors on my brush, sometimes even a couple more, and it'll just be like a varied color stroke, so I'll have multiple colors in one stroke. This provides some visual interest to the piece, and it also allows me to give hints of like colors and shadows and like light bouncing around. One important thing when you're working in an impressionistic style is to think about how you want to portray light and shadows. So I really like using a technique where I'll take multiple colors and mix them together in one brush stroke to help me portray. So out of this piece, I think the dragons were actually the most difficult part to paint. They do have a lot of small bits. So this is actually an 8x8 painting, so it's not huge. And like their legs are really small, especially like the smaller dragon, the spikes on them and the legs are like really small. So they were a little bit more difficult than I initially was thinking they would be to paint, but I really like how they turned out. And I really like how the sky behind them turned out. I really wanted to do like a really vibrant sunset, almost like the whole background was on fire or something, as like a homage to the fact that they're dragons, and they're probably fire-breathing dragons, but in your world, they might be like ice-breathing dragons. I don't know. Dragons are cool, so I'm just really excited by this painting. I'm just going to put it next to my other castle painting, and then it'll just make me happy when I look at it. I really like the painting. I really like how it turned out, and I really like how colorful it is. So really quick, I'm using Winsor & Newton paints, and I'm also using a little bit of the Georgian water mixable oil colors. I like how you can intermix the Winsor & Newton paints, which are a classic oil color, although they do have their own line of water mixable paints. I like how you can mix them with the Georgian water mixable paints. I think that's a really cool feature of them. And because I'm mixing them, I do have to clean up everything with odorless mineral spirits. But I think that gets my brushes cleaner anyway, and it's how I prefer to clean them up. But this is just about the end of my painting. It was a pretty quick painting, all in all. And I do have some footage where I just kind of zoom in so you can see the texture that the painting gets. Because honestly, that is, in my opinion, the best part about these really thick impressionistic style oil paintings that I've been doing, is the texture. And you can also see where I've picked up multiple colors on my brush and made a brush stroke with varying colors in it, I did that quite a lot in this piece, but I just think that seeing the texture is almost like half of the piece. Like, it really brings it to life in person. And I really like how it turned out. I also really like how the colors in the castle turned out. So I tried to make one section of the castle, the top section, a little bit lighter and the bottom section a little bit darker. So you could tell that those bits of the castle were actually separated. So it's not just one flat color of castle. And I really like how that comes across and makes it look like the castle's a little bit more 3D. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. This was a really fun painting to make, and it makes me really happy to look at it on my wall. Hopefully, going forward, I'm going to be making more fantasy paintings, so if you would like to stick around for that, consider hitting the subscribe button. I also have more oil paintings that I have done and that I will be doing in the future. I also did the occasional watercolor and block printing, sometimes a craft, and I would love to have you stick around. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you're having a great day.